Okay, so we have our model analysis complete, and we have our occlusal rims in place with the models mounted on the articulator, and we're good to go ahead with our setup. So a little trick to make things really pretty simple when you're doing a setup, when you have your occlusal rims, you can remove the lower rim from the upper and make a putty matrix of the occlusal plane. So you can use that putty matrix as the occlusal plane and set the teeth up against it, and you'll have the curve that you've established with the occlusal plane and set the upper teeth accordingly, and you can have things all out of the way and put the teeth in a real, real easy manner. So if we sight down the occlusal plane and we can see where two-thirds the way up the retromolar pad kind of lines up with the occlusal plane, and if we had our elastic band, you would see that that would correspond with the occlusal plane. We have that on both sides. So what I'm going to do off camera, we're just going to make this putty matrix by using the Pala Lab putty. I'm using a 90 shore hardness, and we'll mix that up and make the occlusal plane, and then I'm going to cut the plane, whatever putty sticks out here, so I'll have a perfect occlusal plane that we can set the teeth against. So you may or may not know this, but when you're trying to figure out the arc where the anterior teeth go, it's in anatomy, eight heads make a body, and when you spread your arms, we're as wide as we are tall. This, the vault of the arc, if you take a piece of wax and follow the vault of the arc, this arc will also, the arc that you make here will also show where the arc of the teeth would be. And kind of where the cuspids go, if you follow this arc, kind of where the middle, like where the S shape is where the cuspids would be. So you can look at that and kind of think, oh yeah, well, where the arc of the S, you know, where the S, the middle of the S, the cuspids, and you look out here, the first long branch of the rugae, you know, the cuspids are going to come out here, and you can follow that. And what's interesting, the little matrix that I made, you can see that I've just followed the contour of the upper rim, and we've cut the posterior portion, and let's place that on the lower, and you can see two-thirds of the retromolar pad. And when we place our piece of wax, it follows the contour where the cusp would go. So now we have a place. We can set the teeth up. You don't have to bring the matrix up and down. Things are out of the way, and we can do a real easy, fast setup. Okay, so now that we have our occlusal plane in place, and really kind of a setup plate, if you will, made out of putty, and we're ready to start setting the anterior teeth. So the one thing that we do want to do is transfer the midline, and I just used a little Bard Parker to mark the midline, and I made sure that this was the same as our occlusal rim from the upper, and we verified where that was with the vault. And now I have a little wax base plate kind of a little bit out of the way so I can easily set the teeth. So we're going to start up the anterior setup with the position of a central at first. So we'll just take a central and we'll kind of put this into position, and following the contour of our setup plate that we've made, we can position our first tooth. So that's going to go roughly in here. Heat this wax up so it'll stick in place a little bit. So when we place this tooth, Obviously, we want the incisal edge on the plane, and the long axis of the tooth needs to be slightly to the distal. And we want it to be over here on the midline that we've marked. So we get this tooth put into position. Comes down on the occlusal plane. And we'll place our next tooth. So you can see the long axis of the tooth goes slightly to the distal, and you want the incisal edges on the plane. Now, I like to characterize a little bit, and we're going to let the distals be just a little bit longer, just because that's how I would like it to be. This one I'm going to raise up just a little bit. Okay, once we have the centrals in place, we're going to put the laterals. And the laterals also cant slightly to the distal, and we're going to make them so they're just off the occlusal plane just a little bit. And if you want to characterize and have the laterals flare a little bit, then that adds a little bit of character. Something like that. We'll kind of secure those in place with a little bit of wax. We're going to move to the next lateral. Just slightly off the plane. And we want that to cant a little bit to the distal as well. That's going to look pleasing. Now we're going to move to the cuspids. And the neck of the cuspid is a little more prominent, and we're going to come around the corner with that. So we'll tip the distal in just a little bit like that. And then we'll go to the other side. Okay, now the first bicuspid. The buccal and the lingual cusp tip are both on the plane. And it's going to look like that. The second bicuspid, the buccal cusp is on the plane and the lingual cusp is slightly off the plane. And the molar goes into position. the mesial cusp is slightly off the plane. The stamp cusp is on the plane, and the distal buccal cusp is slightly off the plane. It should look something like that. And it's going to look something like that. And we just do the same for the right side. Both cusp tips are on the plane. And here the buccal cusp is on the plane and the lingual cusp is slightly off the plane. The stamp cusp on the first molar is on the plane. The mesial cusp is on the plane, and the second cusp is slightly off the plane. And then our last molar . The mesial buccal cusp is slightly off the plane, and the distal buccal cusp should be about a millimeter, and the lingual stamp cusp is slightly off the plane. And it should look something like this. Now if we look, we have the center of occlusion is coming pretty nicely over the molar, and we're good to go. So now we're ready to put the posteriors in place, and to start the posterior setup, we're going to use the first molar and place it somewhere, hopefully here on the stop line area, and see where that lines up. It should be this mesial cusp is going to go right up into that fossa by the distal of the second molar and the mesial of the first molar, right in here. So we'll put it in place right there like that. You can see how that comes into place real nice. And this is the second molar, and it now everything will just fall right into place. Heat the wax up and bring it in. So the key is to set the maxillary into place, and then the lowers will just fall like little soldiers right where they go. The first bicuspid. and then we do the same to the other side. That molar goes right in here. See how that just goes right up into position? Just like that. Okay, and then we bring this next tooth into position. Now you can see how we have the distal of this cuspid turned for a little characterization. So we may need to bring the mesial aspect of this first bite to get nice occlusion in here. So we can just make that a quick little adjustment. Just going to let him rotate just a little bit, and there we go. Once we have the posteriors in place, then let's go to the anterior. And the long axis on the anteriors, the apex part obviously slants a little bit to the distal, and the incisive portion goes to the mesial. So here we can just start on one side, put the lateral in, the central, and we'll just go around the arch. So here on the right side, all along axis tips this way, and on the left side, the long axis goes the other way, so it looks correct. For the next central. bring these all into position together. And get a little more overjet and overbite. Like that. Now we'll just wax them in place so they'll stay a little better before we start what the next step would be, the festooning. Now we can check our excursions. Go over here and see how things, you can see how they all glide up in kind of a group function. We'll loosen up this condyle and we'll check the other side. And we can check the incisive movement. And I think for a little characterized anterior setup, it looks pretty good. So that's a balanced setup with Mondials with a little characterization in the anterior region.